So what happens if there are repeated states? So if there were repeated states, then, oh, I see. So, okay, so let's imagine that we did outcome-based updates sort of, but without, and we saw repeated states, and all you're really doing is ignoring anything. Oh, I see. Okay. How about this, Michael? Tell me if what I'm saying makes sense. So
Sure.
if we were doing outcome-based updates, then basically you're just looking at all the rewards that you see, the values that you kind of expected along the way, and it's exactly what you have written down before. But if we had a repeated state, then you're basically ignoring anything you learned along the way. So
During the
that's not
episode.
helpful.
Right.
During the episode. So outcome-based updates say learn nothing during the episode. So if your sequence up there, instead of being S1, S2, S3, SF, had been S1, S2, S3, S1, SF, then what would have happened is I would have seen the rewards that I saw, R1, R2, R3, and then some other reward that I would see, let's call it R1 prime or something, I don't know. I would be pretending as if I didn't already know something about state one because I also saw it go from state one to state two and saw a particular reward, R1. I'd be ignoring that. So what this TD1 update lets you do is when you see S1 again and you sort of back up its value, you've actually captured the fact that last time you were in S1, you actually went to S2 and saw reward R1.
So it's like the outcome-based updates now with extra learning or inside the episode learning.
I like it. Beautiful. So is that better?
Let's say yes.
Excellent. That makes me feel good about myself.